obviously it was a it's a special night, and I think our two seniors, when it's senior night, you have a lot of pressure on you, your family's here, and you're expected to perform, and I thought those two performed at the highest level. I can't say enough about those two, their leadership this year, and their will to win. And those two are special. They're special young women, and just obviously, I'm extremely proud of our team and our staff to get an SEC championship.
Coach, cutting down the net, this is your first year, and you're going to see the Raiders for the title. What was the feeling going through your head? What was your thoughts when you were putting that around?
It was a little bit of disbelief, I guess I didn't know how to act because I've not ever done that before. But excited, obviously extremely, extremely excited for this program and our players. And it's just a great opportunity and to make sure we carry on the tradition that Coach Summitt has done and so it's a little surreal for me right now.
Ollie, you've had one player going up the ladder with an ice pack on it, getting off crutches and doing it.
Yeah, we won, but we almost lost half our team. But John, it's just what we've been battling and dealing with all year, and our team was pretty upset, especially right after Izzy went out, to have two of our players go down, and some of them were crying, upset, but they held on, and that's the resilience of this team. And I mean, they've been hit and they've been knocked down, and they keep getting back up, and it's amazing of how they perform in certain. And under the circumstances that they have all year.
Any early word on both injuries?
I think they've both been checked out, and I honestly, I'm not sure.
Holly, early on, A&M got the ball inside with relative ease to Bo. She scored four pretty easy baskets. Did you make that? And she said she thought you guys were more on the outside and got more help in there against her. Did you say anything?
We did. I thought what was key for us is we started putting more pressure on the ball. When we were pressuring the ball and we were leaving Bashar and Izzy and them to defend her one-on-one, it's difficult. She's just you can't do it. She's strong. She's physical. And we needed help. And so we fronted her at times with help side. We played behind and helped in. But I think probably the key for us is moving out and putting more pressure on the basketball.
Holly, talk about Jordan, what she did for the whole game, but really in the first half, she got you going with that up with those offensive rebounds.
She was awesome today. I thought she came up with just key offensive rebounds, and then down the stretch she hit those two jumpers at the free throw line, and you know, if you didn't look at the stat sheet, I think for Sierra, you would think she's having a good game, and then you pick it up, and she's got 14 rebounds. I think there were 9 offensive rebounds. She's scoring, has a great percentage, and she's just a steady, go-to, reliable player. And asked her tonight, I said, Kamiko's going to start for her being a senior, and was just – she just totally, totally on board, and I thought she was key tonight as well. Huge. I think it was her best game. I think it was her best game by far. I think she had to play long minutes. I think she was tired, but she battled back. Any other game or down or younger in her career, she would have come out. She would have been pulling her shirt. I want out. She didn't do that tonight. She didn't want out. We got her out to give her a couple of breathers, but she competed. She had to go. She had to be huge on defense for us. And then we were asking her to come down, and she was making layups. And I think it was her best game to date. And that's our expectations of Kamiko, and as she's had a really good year, she had a great game tonight.
She's the type of player, so I don't know what you're going to get from her. What did you sense that this was going to be a big night?
Well, I thought she was really focused on in practice. And I think from the jump ball, from the get-go, I thought she was really in tune with what we had to do. She was very receptive on the bench, was very attentive on the bench, and she wanted to be out there and play and make plays and be a part of this of the game. So when she does that, she's reaching her potential. At times, I think she hadn't reached her potential, but tonight she was awesome.
Hey Holly, replacing Pat, a legend, being picked fifth, winning the SEC championship, is this a sense of validation for you?
I think it's a sense of validation for these young players, because we're mainly freshmen and sophomores, and we've asked them to play big roles. I mean, they're trying to live up a tradition that Pat has built, and it's tough. It is tough, and there's a lot of pressure on them. But I will tell you this: they have battled and asked. They have done what we've asked them to do. I mean, you see everybody play an important role. Ariel stepping up and playing the minutes she played. Sierra coming in. Izzy, and then our freshman. It's just an tribute to. I will say this: they didn't like being picked fifth. So they had a little chip on their shoulder, and they went to work. They went to work, and I think they this is the one team that I will tell you has been the most focused, has the hardest working team in practice that we have had here in a very long time. So when you do those things, you get great results, and it's been a huge, huge team effort. Well, I'm biased. I think she should be freshman of the year. Absolutely, she's stepped up big for our team, and I mean her stats and how she plays speaks for herself. But yeah, I'm telling you as her coach, yes.
All right, coach.
All right, thank you all.